Good evening, everyone. Hope you're all doing well and staying safe in this quarantine period. So I welcome you all today to today's online interactive session for insights into architectural studies. I'm Architect Adhika, and today we have with us Architect Loganathan sir. He's Dean of Chettinad School of Architecture. Joining us is today's guest speaker, Dr. Bhaskaran Manoharan sir. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Yes. He did his graduation from Indian Institute of Architects, Mumbai, in the year 2001, and he has done his postgraduate from PMIST and PhD from Tamil Nadu University. He's doing his postdoctoral studies in as a research fellow in Lincoln University, Malaysia. His area of research is psychology in architecture with special emphasis on environmental psychology and memory association. He's the founder chairman of Indian Institute of Architects in Tanjore. He's also a practicing architect and consultant to various government organizations, educational institutions, financial institutions, private agencies and societies like ICCW, Amrita Vishwa Vidyadipam, Indian Red Cross Society, and nationalized banks. Apart from this, architecture, his passion also includes short film making and singing. He has done two short films to his credit, done under the support of Film Institute of India, Pune, and Auroville Film Institute. I take immense pleasure in welcoming you, sir.
Thank you
for joining
you.
Us in this interactive session. So, yeah, now, over,
you.
Over to you, sir.
Good evening, participants. Good evening, sir. Loganathan, sir. And good evening, fellow architects who have arranged all these things. Nice of you to be here in the evening. The insight into architectural studies, this is what Loganathan, sir, has, the dean has given to talk about what's architectural studies and all to the students, this prospective students who are coming into architecture, and give an insight into their parents or even some other architects who want to do some higher studies and all. That's why I'm here. So I have structured this talk into these five categories. Like I wanted to define what is architecture, then what is architectural education. How an architect goes for the practice, and what are all the higher studies, and then I want to conclude this. These things are, I have done it in a very, very basic level. I think almost all are, the beneficiary is the student. So I have structured in that way, very lucid and very, a basic level only, whereby you can understand what is architecture. And if you are interested, you can come into the this professional group of architects. I think you'll after the end of the session, you'll decide to come into this profession because of its wealthy whatever you can say. As you all know, architecture, the name or the word you would have heard in your life so many times. So what's architecture and all? You see, these initially we were all living in caves and all. Slowly human started living in a built area, built structure, and then after some days, this small residential buildings have given given birth to a lot of culture and literature, and then from literature, the histories and all, everything came, and they developed their knowledge, and then they started constructing small huts, then they went on to construct big buildings. Like in India, we have our ancient structures, we have a lot of big good temples, which has a very intrinsic detailed carving work and all, which you can very rare to see in any other part of the world. For example, you take Bragadeshwara temple, nearly it is 1,000 years old, and the technique which our Indian architects have, Indian artisans, in those days they called them as artisans. Those artisans have done wonderful work, like in big temple, and then we have a Sanchi stupas, a Buddhist thing by Ashoka and all, and we have in Orissa the Sun Temple, and we won't never cannot forget this Taj Mahal. Like this, just I am giving a small basic introduction. Yeah, next we have this Agra, this Red Fort and Red Fort, India Gate, and we have this. After this, these things are all in India. Previously, we had a temple architecture. Then slowly, this Mughal came. We had a lot of buildings in Mughal architecture, like Taj Mahal and Red Fort. Then this Indo-Saracenic by British people, they have blended both this contemporary in those period and then the previous existed Indian this native architecture. You see the detailing of carvings in the Sun Temple and Brahmeshwar Temple and Tanjavur. So this is all about this architecture, which you know, I think. You normally, as an layman, people think architecture is something like beautification, some intricate work, carvings and all. This is what you will be all knowing, but it is not. It is, but it is not only that. It is much, much, much and much more than that. That's the thing which every aspiring architectural student should know. So basically, I can give you some 10 types of styles existing in India. Initially, it was temple architecture, it had Dravidian architecture, and then Nagara, and then a blend of this Dravidian and Nagara, Visara architecture and all. It was a temple architecture. It was there in our blood, actually. I can say you may be a Dravidian or a North Indian or any other part of from India. If you have the culture of Indian culture, you in your blood, there will be this what you call architectural element in your blood. Should be, it will be there, because every day we have from our early childhood, we would have seen places of architectural importance, and grown up after seeing those places, and in our memory we can relate our age. Maybe we would have seen a particular temple or some built structure of ancient which would have been impressed you. When you go to the same place again, you will remember your old days. That's the power of Indian architecture, which makes us as a society. I can say one thing: this Indian, this architectural, output has developed or have molded the society culturally, spiritually, and whatnot. We can say, comparing any other westernized cultures, we are our culture are so I cannot say it is policed. Moral policed or something. I don't say that those words, but anyhow, it has regulated. This society has been regulated by architecture, I can say. So as an architectural aspiring student, you should know architecture is not only, as I said earlier, built structure. Again, after this temple architecture, this Mughal period. In Mughal period, you would have seen all Taj Mahal, Red Fort, Agra, all those things. You would have learnt in your history, I think, in your school days. So after this Mughal, we had Indo-Saracenic. That is, you can see it is a revival architecture. This British came into India in 17th century. Then 16th, and then this British East India Company. Afterwards, this directly the empire has to cover Indian, the country of India. In that, they have blended this the contemporary architecture of the those periods with our architectural styles. And then we have derived in our own derived in architecture, which is prevailed in Tamil Nadu, this region, southern India, part of the. I think you'll be knowing about it. This pyramid shaped, complex carved stones, structures in stone. And then in Kalinga architecture, where you have Sun Temple, Konark, all those things, where it is part of Orissa now. And then again, the Sikh architecture, where you have a very superb example of the Golden Temple. And it has intricate carvings, so minute carvings, beauty. And it has a progressive design. It has this Sikh architecture. Then Visara, it's a blend of, again, this combination of Dravida and Nagara. Maybe Nagara, if you call it as a northern thing, and Dravida, the southern architecture, temple architecture, this Visara, combined both of this, and you have a lot of these things in Karnataka. And then normally, another thing we have in, we have our Indian vernacular architecture. Actually, it is very informal. They'll do whatever they do with their own understanding of a particular built space, building. They will not be copying, they will not be doing any formal designs. They'll be doing informal, whatever. If they want to paint the wall, they will be just painting, and they'll be doing cow dung. If they want to have any drawings in the wall, they'll put their hand in lime, and then they'll keep their hands on the wall, and it will become a different type of patterns, and they say it is vernacular, something like that. So again, we had a cave architecture where Buddhist viharas and Jain monasteries were functioning in BC, before Christ it was, 3rd century BC before Christ. And then we have a rock cut architecture even before that, where solid rock is cut by hand tools and all. Everything was done by hand. So such is the vast knowledge in the blood of Indians about the constructional practice and as well as architecture. Sir, next slide, sir. Yeah, again, what I said, this East India Company in this 17th century, and then British rule. This period only we had Indo-Saracenic architecture. I would like to say a few things about how the present architecture came into being, in the present architectural profession and present architectural studies came into being. I had to go to this British period, where British, after the British crown, crown took over India from the East India Company, they wanted to have a lot of their own office buildings. So they took help from the British architects. They borrowed British architects from UK, and then British architects were given the job of constructing all types of buildings. In Chennai, you are having this Ripon building, and then even this central station and all. They are all done by those people only. Later, there were some additions. That's a different thing. Also, those British architects came to India, and they started this style of architecture. Indian architects learned from them. Indian architects learned from them the nuances or the architectural construction techniques, where concrete, previously the material concrete and those things were not much used. But actually, before advent of cement, these Indo-Saracenics started with lime only. They have used lime vastly, lime material. Lime was the material. Then slowly they have changed to a cement, and all the buildings have been constructed by them. In that, the British, to help the British architects, Indian architects were trained, and then in that way, Indian architects became known about the nuances of the architectural construction practice of the Western world. So, in order to have it in a structured way or in a professional way, this JJ School of Architecture was started in 1913 by the. It was Sir Jamshedji ji. It was started in 1913. That is the first school of architecture in the whole of Asia. And from there only, almost all architects or architectural seniors have started. They learned architecture, then they practiced. You can say many architects from Asia have learned from there. From 1913, the practice of architecture was done in a what you call it. It was not the clarity of architecture. Architectural practice was not there. Whoever passed out from JJ School of Architecture, they were considered as architects of high caliber, but. Parallelly, many other parallel professional people were also doing architectural designs and all. But comparatively, the works of the architects, qualified architects from these schools, spoke volumes. Volumes of what an architecture is, how an architecture is. Not just it is not just a built space, but it is much, much, much more than that. It was the difference that these architects who were qualified out of these schools, JJ School of Architecture, such as the schools, after some days, these architects have proved to the society that the architects' designs are a holistic design. So that's in India, the practice of architecture started. So now I had given you what is architecture and all those things. How architecture came to India. So what, as people, you had come for this course to study architecture, you'll be having a doubt, what is architecture? As I said earlier, now you can understand if I explain what is architecture. Architecture is art and science of designing and creating spaces. It's art and science. You see, many people say art, differentiation between two things. What is art and what is science? I can say, when arts end, science begins, and at times when science ends, arts begins. I can give an example. If I'm doing a design of a building, as an architect, I create a building. If I'm doing a building and it's a basic design, means I'm doing a building with all the problems which are given to me, I have designed a building. That is a design for that particular requirement. Okay, if a small requirement changes with the same design, the design will change. So, but if I done a design and it is repetitively used or the same way, it means that you are using it on a repeated basis. Like the science and engineering will be like that. If you design a building, if you design a beam, or if you take in case of designing a beam, like in civil engineering, they used to design beams and all. What is the load in the beam? How much what will be the soil capacity to withstand that beam and all? This will be designed in civil engineering. After that, only how much load is coming on the structure, they'll design roof and all. But in science and engineering, if I design, the value will be the same if even the other person will design. The values will not change in science and engineering. It is not specific to a person. But art is different, totally different. Even if I do an art now, and if I want to repeat the same art even after a day or two, it will change. I'll change. That's the difference between art and science. So, artists are always creators, and scientists and engineers are followers. I think so. As an architect, you are a blend of art and science. So you have what you call, when you come out, you come out of this course, you will be an artist with a science and the engineering capabilities, where you will not only have these two, you will be having humanities also into it. So this is such a wonderful course whereby you become a human professional with a human touch, or human becoming a professional like that. You will not leave the human thing. The course makes you like that only. You can ask any architect or any architect practicing, or any type of architect. He may practice any type of style or anything, but the basic, if you ask him, he'll have a humanistic behavior or humanistic value, or you can say he'll be more human than something non-human or inhuman. So that is what architecture is. Again, profession of designing, the profession of designing building, as I said, not only designing buildings, designing open spaces. If there is no open space, there is no meaning for a building. This is just like a frame. If you want to have a beautiful painting, if you don't have a frame, this painting, the visual converge, if you see the painting, you will not converge into the painting if you don't have a frame. So the open spaces are just like a frame to a building in a smaller level. Open spaces in urban level, like a park, roads, all those things are all like a frame to the urban spaces. It is like that. So it has a connection between both. This spaces support the built structure, and the built structure supports the open spaces. So finally, what is architecture? I can reiterate, it is an art, a knowledge of art, science, and humanities. The comparing engineering and other fields, parallel professions, this science may be there, or engineering may be there, but it will lack humanities and art. Sir, next slide, sir. Yeah, definition. Sir, next slide, sir. Next, yeah, thank you. Then, sir, previous slide. Okay, sir, next slide. Thank you. Next slide, sir. Thank you. Yeah, who is an architect? As I said, what is architecture? About built spaces, which is having art, knowledge of art, and humanities and science. Same way, the person who practices that is architects. So he should have the qualities of all these things. Like he will be a person who will be recognized by the particular professional body. In India, we have a COA, Council of Architecture. That is the body which recognizes the architectural profession. And that is, you have to get registered after doing your BR into that, and you can practice, your architectural practice. You can have your architectural practice. And in as an architect, you will be having a skill in skill in the art of designing buildings to meet clients' needs. Because after all, you are doing any building or any built space to the needs of somebody else, not yours, somebody else. You will be understanding what the somebody else needs, his wants, and then accordingly you will be designing the buildings. For this, you will be using all other the things, all the art and science and humanities, which you had learned from this five-year course to better use. Finally, what will happen, the result, outcome result will be an added advantage. Aesthetics will also join in that final result. So normally people used to say architects building means they had notion, maybe wrong or right, I should not say that, maybe partially right, partially wrong. This wrong notion where this architects build, buildings are they are giving only importance to looks and all, that's appearance. But it is not the case. The appearance and looks automatically into the design. It'll mingle into the design when an architect starts designing a building. That will also join. He will not go in particularly for that, but you see, on the process of design, it will come along, and the final product will have a functional and aesthetic feel. So this public feels that this functional feel will be indirectly. It will not be known openly. It will be indirect. It will be indirectly visible. That will be visible only to the user. But the visual, aesthetic sense and all that is visual. So it attracts and it gives more input to the viewer. And so viewer feels that this is an architect building. They say it looks nice. But more than this beauty, it is the functionality will be there. So that's what is an architect is. Sir, next slide, sir. Yeah. So after being a profession, architect being a profession, in India we have four professional bodies. One for law, they have Bar Council of India. Another for Medical Council of India, medicine. Another for this Chartered Accountants and Cost Accountants, they have a council. And for architects also, we have a council. So we have four councils in India, and one more council, this Valuers Council, is in the process. They have the draft Valuers building is on the process. So in India, we have at present we have only four councils, and Council of Architecture is one among them, one of it. Sir, next, sir. So now, what is the role of an architect? So you have become an architect. How you function normally? Apart from the designer, if you have an office, you'll be in. You have to know what is accounting and all. Not fully, at least basic accounts and all you'll be doing. So you'll be acting as an audit. You'll be acting as an auditor also for your in your office, and then you'll be as you are a social conscious person. Whatever you design, you will be thinking whether this particular design will affect the environment. That's what in our again previous definition of architecture we said: art, science, and humanities. Though that humanities is the social consciousness of an architect. So an architect is normally a social conscious person when he comes into the practice. He doesn't want to be a social conscious person, even then he will be automatically after doing a few, because of initially for compulsion and all that. New architects, when they start their own building, the small buildings and all, there will be a lot of compulsions from the person who has given the work, or the contractor, or the engineer who has given the work, or the owner himself. So in those times, they will be having they may not try to, they may not be able to do it. But after some days, the consciousness inside an architect will not allow you to do non-social conscious architecture. That's a great thing about human. You'll become a human as an architect. If you become an architect, you become more human than any other professional work, I think. Next slide. So in architecture, we have in professions, it is controlled. The scopes of architecture is for your education and all, and Indian Institute of Architects for your professional practice. That is, Council of Architecture is for citizens of India, and Indian Institute of Architects is for the benefit and welfare of architects alone. This Council of Architects is constituted under the Architects Act 1972, which was again proposed by IAA, Indian Institute of Architects, in 19. This Council of Architecture only gives the recognition for an architect to practice. All disputes and all will be solved in by the Council of Architecture between a client and an architecture or non-architects practicing as an architect. All those things legal. Yeah. Again, what I previously said, this knowledge of art, science, and humanities. Again and again, I'm reiterating it because your mold will, if initially starting stages itself, if your mold is like that, you can be a better architect from your studies. So what this design activities or architect is basically from micro to macro. Or normally we think of if a particular building is to be designed by an architect, initially the micro level, like under that building, forms the basis of the design. Normally we used to call scale to part and part to scale. That is also another thing. But micro to macro means we have a particular building, means we not only stop with that designing of that building. Because of that building, what all other socio or environmental changes that building will make or can make, or it can spoil, something like that. Think of normally as an architect, we think of it as an architect. You will also think of it on your future days. If there is a very big good hospital in the vicinity, and the next to the hospital, if a client wants to try to make you build a very big factory which is giving a lot of noise, as a conscious architect, you will not accept the work. Not only any architect will not accept the work, even if he accepts the work, he will see that this noise pollution is not going into goes to that particular hospital or affects that. So that is the way in which architects try to design micro to macro. They design micro to macro, and then compare, and they'll check whether it is correct from macro to micro. Like if there is a water supply drainage quantity of drain, this drainage pipe given by the particular authorities in a particular residential settlement area, residential complex, maybe the society, so the architect thinks about what's the volume of water or drainage or sewage goes into the drain, and how many buildings can be designed to cater to that particular, the drainage can cater to how many buildings, and such number of more buildings, if there is necessity or if it's a compulsion to do, he will advise the local authorities to go for a bigger drainage pipes and all. That is the way an architect interacts with the society and the other authorities also. This one part. Another part, this as an architect, you will have a design team where you will be supervising, you'll be understand you in your course you'll be you'll be you would understand structures, mechanical, electrical, air conditioning services and all. You have a subject for this, for that. You'll be understanding that. In practice also, when you go out, these things you will apply with the proper guidance. These things where you will you will control or you will advise your parallel or your co staffs, your design team, to do the works in such a way or design the work in such a way. So aesthetics, as it is, as I told you earlier, it comes automatically on the process of design. Sir, next slide, sir. Yeah, this small example which I have given, how an architect goes for a smaller design. Just he starts with one rectangle. This is a design process. You may not be understanding this, but I gave it just to an architect's design is not a single day's work. It is not a single idea taken in a paper, drawn with two or three lines and all. It is not the case. It is a process where he first understands the site. He understands the site, and he understands what type of building needs to be done in the site, and then he should know. He will be knowing who are the people who are using it. So these parameters is he uses to design a building. For designing, again he'll use that art, his knowledge in arts, his knowledge in science, and his knowledge in humanities. These three things he used for this design, for the design process, and finally he comes out with the design. And this design he can be reviewed, and he can give whatever doubts asked by the client or whomsoever for whom he has designed this building. So this is the design process. So this design process is totally taught in schools, in architectural schools. So again, I'll come to the definition of schools. You will see all other things are all many institutions are called as colleges. So why it is school, architect schools? You see, it is just like starting from not knowing much about thing. It is like that. It's architecture. Normally, you will say, you will feel that I don't know drawing, I don't know this, I don't know that. But even then, being a school, this 5-year course, this normally, they'll the thing is the curriculum is like you are taught arts, you are taught science and humanities as it is in arts, all history of architecture, all these things, and then even the sketchings and all, the color schemes, color wheel, all those things will be there, and where you will be known with all the things. And if you are good at sketch, if you good at sketching, it will be better. But if you don't know sketching, no problem. Actually, the thing is that this 5-year course makes you come out with a complete professional. So that's why it's called a school. Normally colleges, I should say arts college, no, or arts institutions are called as schools. Like the same way architectural institutions are also called as schools. So in school you will be taught like this, and you'll come out with a complete professional. So it is a next level in, I'm talking about practice in architecture now. This in architecture we have comprehensive services where we'll be involved in site evaluation. You see, this is Council of Architecture directs wants an architect to do. See, the site evaluation, analysis, and impact of existing and or proposed development on its immediate environs. This is where an engineering or arts differs. This
this environment factor, no engineering or no science, no what you call scientific design people will take into consideration. As an architect, he is concerned about environs also. So this is one of the requirement of an architect as per the Council of Architecture's norms. So again, the same thing again, it is coming art, science, and then humanities. This environment comes in the humanities. So as a comprehensive services, he'll be having design of design and the site development. He'll be knowing structural design. He'll be knowing the basics of structural design, where he can guide the structural designer to have his design in such a way that it caters to his architectural needs, like that. And he'll be knowing here the sanitary plumbing. These are all I have. This including the elevators. I'm not going very deep into it. So these are the component services. This is our, when you come into the architectural course, you'll be knowing much more about it. So I'm not going very deep into it. Some four, these five allied fields are there in architecture, like landscape architecture, interior architecture. The name itself says this landscape architecture is, you know, that this green architecture. It is so interior architecture and the architectural conservation. Conservation means if there is any a building which is of having some heritage value. Heritage means building built some years, some periods later, before. So they want to have the building intact, but without changing, the building would have been damaged. Without changing the original character of the building, they would want to have it. So that's called a conservation. Architects used to do that also. Very, very great conservation architects are there in the field in southern India, and intact is taken care of those Indian heritage structures. They are taking care of it by help of this architects, conservation architects. The retrofitting of buildings, existing building will be designed by an architect, and then previously having some needing some additions because of change in soil conditions or something, or calamities or unnatural things and all. Again, the buildings will be retrofitted by expert opinions from the structural people with the guidance of the architects and all those. That is an allied field for these architects. And then graphic design and signage, that is, you know, as it is nowadays, everything is digital. It has come into the architect's domain now. So after, you see, normally people say that architect, yes, he does buildings. Whether it is true, it's not actually. Architects not only do buildings. This course is that you develop on your own. Normally you develop on your own, and your passion makes you choose a path. You'll go to a path, you'll take a path, or you'll divert. You will not be diverting. You'll be having the basics of architecture, but you'll be taking your own passion into your hands, and you'll try to explore a new thing. So I can say this architecture can make you into that also, like art direction. If you go for art direction and all, you would have seen this Amaran. Amaran is a very good art director. He has done many films for Maniratnam and all, I think. Amaran. So this basic, he's an architect. His basic knowledge in architecture and his basic knowledge in architecture helped him to choose that profession and excel in it. He's excelling in a great way in that profession, art direction. And then product designer, like being an architect, you'll have an idea of what a material is, and what is a design is, what is the human anthropometry and all. We say anthropometry means the measurement of hand, legs and all relative to your built space or the things which you use. normal day to life. So with that, the product designer, they may design a chair for a different differently abled person. So if architects can design in a better way, those things, if the passion is that, they can go for that too. That's product design. Like not only in medical field, they can go into any type of building materials, from handles to the chairs to kitchen equipment, anything you can, they can go for a product as a product designer. But now the requirement for good product designers is very high. It is, requirement is very high, and very less number of product designers are there in the field. So these are the things which you can go for naval architecture, in naval, navy and all, or the ships and all, the interiors, everything, those things can be done, are done by the architect. As I please say, conservation architect, you can go as a conservation architect, where you will be conserving heritage buildings with the help of authorities, local authorities or agents, government agencies like that. And then a very important one, the architectural journalism. You see, a journalist, if writing an architectural column or architectural this write-up, may not be able to give completely, or the clarity of the writing may not be that much good than an architect. So if an architect becomes a journalist after architecture, I have seen a few architects in Salem and Chennai and all. No? Chennai, his name is Selva Prakash, and in Salem there is Komagal Arpoma. She was a Wigadan journalist. She's an architect, teaches in various schools. And she's a Wigadan journalist. She was a junior Wigadan journalist, something like that. She was. She continues still, I think. So again, aircraft design, in the design of aircraft, the seating arrangements, all those things, the furniture design. And then as an architect, you can be an artist also. And some very well-known artists are architects, Satish Gujral and all, or good painters and artists. And then you can be a filmmaker. Many filmmakers in Mumbai are there. We have Joseph Kosinski, is a noted filmmaker and a graphic designer. Architectural photography is there, because as architects, we take photographs to document our buildings. So some architects have very good passion for photography. So we architects use them to take the photographs, and they are all very heavily paid photographers. We pay to promote our building designs or to show to our other clients, prospective clients and all. Then now architectural visualization, 3D modeling, it is because nowadays all digital has come. Architect can enter into that field also after this course and all. As you know, this construction and project management is the basic thing of an architect, that is always there for an architect. Now, this is a small graphical visual representation, and that's all. So you see, you'll be surprised. Ratan Tata is an architect. You see this architectural journalism. See, we have given career emerging specialization in the field of architecture, career in architecture, career in art and design, and career outside of outside of the design. You know, all those things, architectural journalism, architectural photography, construction project management, landscape architecture, urban planning, and then lighting architect. It is an interesting field now, lighting architect, where this architect knows, studies further about lighting, in a built space as well as in an open space, whereby he can contribute to the optimum or better lighting for a particular type of work. It is like that. And we have even one of my friend in Film Institute of Pune. He's doing VR. He's doing sound. He's doing some research on sound. So you see, being an architect, he wants to understand what sound is. Like if you are sitting in a home, how the sounds coming from other places, like a far off place, for some 3 houses later or 2 houses near or just in front of you, how sound affects you, what type of sound it can support you for your work. Maybe you may be a patient, or you may be a painter, or you there it may be a factory, or it may be a what do you call a library. So how the sound affects this particular usable area, usable space. He's studying that. So I'm talking, this is the scope of architecture studies. It's very vast and it's very vast. There's no words about it. So that's why I wanted to show this. Even you'll be knowing this architect, one architect's a politician. This Israel president Netanyahu, he's a politician. So just I wanted to show this because it is what are all as an architect after doing, or what are all the how an architectural studies has made and propelled a man to become all these things. For that only I show this. Nothing more than that. This is what I have already said. That's architectural journalism. After doing this, you can go. And this photography, architectural photography. How this after completing his architecture, he has gone for this photography, and how people have come out with the different. Photograph different viewing positions in photographs. Yeah, as it is a construction manager. This is what was impact of globalism in architecture. I think before this globalization, after this 1990s, the scope of architecture and materials were not there for architects to go for design. Now, after globalization, you are given with abundant materials. Whatever you want to practice, you want to design in a particular building for the necessity, for the requirement of that particular building. Because of this globalization, it is available. You can make it available. You can get it from anywhere in the world to any place in the world. So that globalization has improved architectural designing scope. That is the thing which I presume from this globalization, which I have understood by doing a lot of buildings. Whatever design I perceive in my thing, I can go for it. So that is a great opportunity for all upcoming architects, where this is profession profession is architectural profession, as we say. This is occupation. Being in a professional architect, you'll be better than an occupation oriented job oriented person. Normally you'll have ethics with you normally. You'll have a humanistic value, as I said earlier. But in occupation, normally occupation means I am talking about a job. But in architecture, the junior architects which we have in our office, or this architectural team which we have, even though they are doing a job, they are not, we don't call them as, it is not an occupation. They are professionals having their own identity, their own freedom of design, and the team forms, the design is complete. After so many discussions within the team, with inputs, individual inputs, creative inputs from all of the team members, like that. So that is the difference where, as an architect, if he goes for a job or if he has his own office, that freedom, that is the thing which makes this profession different from any other profession. Yeah, as I said earlier, this comprehensive services, after this course only, but basically I have already said. This is allied field which I have already told, this landscape architecture, interior architecture. This is what I want to say. BRK is a 5-year course. Normally other things are 4-year courses, this 5-year course. Because it's a school. And IITs and very few NITs offer campus placement. So you may think, many after completing architecture, my colleagues or my juniors or my seniors are getting a campus placement, and I'm not getting like that. But the thing is, if you think in a longer term, if you see a doctor, if you see a lawyer, normally these lawyers, doctors, and all professionals, they may be getting very, very less campus placement. They don't care about campus placements. Even if they go for jobs, initially they get very meagerly paid. Same case with architects also. But after some days, when you prove yourself, there is no limit for your earning, and there is no limit for your designing. You are designing as per your designing capacities. You learn more. And being an architecture, when you take architectural studies as a passion, when you do it with a willing heart and willing mind, you can do wonders. So that's what I can perceive comparing the campus placements and all after doing architecture. So first, as an architect, after doing how to be an independent professional architect, that's enough. Then everything will come into place automatically. And I can say, architects are never unemployed. Architects, as per their profession, as per their passion, they can have employment in any field of their passion, and there is no dearth of unemployment. So that's it for me, for architectural fraternity, and best of luck for all of you aspiring architects coming into this field, and see you all us graduated as architects after 5 years.
Yeah, thank you, sir. It was a wonderful presentation. Actually, suddenly we were many centuries back. Then you took us around the globe. You took us around so many historical icons. Then you told us what is architecture or what is the architecture studies. A very deep insight into the studies and how it evolves. How actually architecture here evolves a man, how architecture evolves somebody into a very good social being, and so many and so on and so forth things. And then you went deep into what is the practice and all that. And there were many questions, but then somehow many of the questions have been answered in your
I said, is there any
there was something like, no, how do we differ from engineers and those kind of things. You very precisely you said, creativity backed by science knowledge, an architect always makes the technician.
Yeah, humanity is engineering and architecture different. The different main difference is only two things: arts and humanities. Arts and humanity. If you take arts and humanities from architecture, engineering or science will be there.
Okay, super.
If it is an engineering, it doesn't have art. It doesn't have humanities.
Very well said, sir. Actually, I think reducing all the questions that came up, I think we can. I have only one thing to ask you at the end of the day.
Sir,
how does it feel as an architect, number one? Okay. And what is the prosperity an architect can look for? Okay, straight to the target.
Yeah, true.
What is the prosperity then? Okay,
yeah.
I think with this question, with this question, we will move on to our video.
Okay.
Which will be the last part of the session.
Okay, yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
So first question you are asked, how do you feel as an architect, is it?
Yes.
Next
and
question?
What is the prosperity?
Okay.
What
okay.
is the prosperity an architect can see?
Okay, okay. Sir, how do you feel as an architect? For that, the best thing which I can have in my life, being an architect. You see, I have my passion into my profession. So it is like that. In Tamil, they say used to say, "Na karumbu thinna kooliya." It is like in Tamil. You see, you are offered a sugar cane and you are offered money also, like that. So I have taken this architecture as a profession passionately, and I am doing passionately, so I don't get tired. Whatever I am doing in my profession, my work, I feel it is happily I am doing. So there is no that's the thing one needs in their life, you know. So that's what to me. And the next is this prospect is, you see, it depends on individual person's perception. For me, I may say sitting in bank of a river thinking of something may give happiness. And even if you say, if you for some money may be happiness. In architecture, you can decide your own path. If you want to make money, if you have passion to make money, it is there. The chances are there how to make money as per your passion. And the same way, if you want to be socially too much constrained, be happy, individual barefoot architects like walking in barefoots and all. If you want to be like that also, you can be doing it. So it's all final result is the happiness now, happiness in life. That's what is giving this profession gives me that more than money. Thank you, sir, for that question. Good question they have asked.
Yeah, wonderfully said, Dr. Manoharan.
service.
Sir, actually these are works of our students.
Nice, sir. I was just watching it.
They have used to know whatever available materials and then they made.
All materials they have and they had an on hand
whatever scrap material whatever they had.
It's great with
These are just a specimen of
nice. They have done ceramics. I am wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. They have done.
This is a small part of something that was done in the first semester. So we thought what is the something different that is in architecture studies. We are really grateful for your acceptance to spend such a wonderful. Valuable time with us, and we certainly look forward to your physical presence at our campus.
Sure, call me at the earliest. I'll be there. Yeah. I'll be there.
Yeah. Radhika, please, thanks.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for spending your valuable time and taking the effort to do the presentation. It was very insightful and very, I'm sure all of whom are present would have been benefited from that. So thank you so much, sir. And we're looking forward to having you at our premises soon, sir.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And,
thank you.
Thank you, Logan, sir. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you.